Good evening. The Chinese authorities are warning that they face a severe shortage of beds and equipment to treat the growing number of people with coronavirus as it spreads rapidly across the country and abroad. Nearly 500 people have now died and tens of thousands of others have been infected. 74 million people are now under some sort of travel restriction, with many being told not to leave their homes. Meanwhile, thousands of passengers and crew on two cruise ships have been placed in quarantine after a number of people on board tested positive for the virus. One ship is docked in Hong Kong. The other, this one, the Diamond Princess, is off the coast of Japan. More on that in a moment. But first, John Sudworth reports from Beijing.
Wuhan is a city at war with an invisible enemy. And they're trying everything they can to defeat it. State media is now full of images of a heroic struggle. The brand new hospitals held up as proof it's won their winning. But Xiao Huang is not so sure. It took him days to find his granddad a bed in this hospital corridor. Shortly after this video was taken, he was dead. He fears his grandmother, who also has the virus, is dying too. If they'd been admitted earlier, of course things would have been better, he tells me. Wuhan is overwhelmed by illness, with hundreds more cases than available beds, and these patients hooked up to makeshift drips. One woman who doesn't want to be identified tells me that her uncle's death won't even be counted in the official statistics. There are so many cases like his, she says. This is the death certificate. He never made it to hospital. All of this might have been prevented. In mid-January, knowing the virus was already spreading fast, the authorities allowed this massive community banquet to go ahead, putting the economy and political stability ahead of public health. With the epidemic raging, travel records show 5 million people were able to leave Wuhan before the city was finally locked down. With infections now taking hold across China, other cities have begun imposing restrictions. In Nanyang, Hangzhou, Wenzhou, Harbin, only one person per household is allowed out to buy food once every 2 days. The increasing disruption is why some countries, including the UK, are advising people to leave. Others are getting out anyway.
Yeah, quite a bit disappointed, but I think it's okay because they're trying to keep us safe.
The cost of all this is immeasurable. This was the middle of Beijing in what should be the middle of a working week. The ruling Communist Party knows that as well as economic, there are political risks in all of this. The deep public anger that officials didn't do enough to tell people what they knew soon enough, which is why we've seen the highly unusual step of the ruling Politburo admitting this week that mistakes were made. The big question now, of course, can they fix this? With the propaganda in overdrive, the remotest corners are getting the public health message. But China faces a long journey yet. Well, Sophie, if China's rigid political system helped accelerate this crisis in the first place, and the irony is those same tools of authoritarianism might help it to tackle it. The shutting down of whole cities, the ordering of tens of millions of people to stay indoors is hard to imagine in almost any other society. And outside of...
Apologies, we have lost the line there to Beijing, but that was John Sudworth with the latest there. Here, the government is chartering one more flight